My name is Anthony Maddaloni. I'm a professional photographer from Austin, Texas. I'm going to talk about pinhole cameras and what a pinhole really does in a camera. Pinhole is essentially your aperture. And what you're doing is you can do it a few different ways. You can make a pinhole, some people call them a zone plate, out of a piece of aluminum, piece of metal. And what you're doing is essentially what the name is you're putting a tiny little hole into that piece of metal, and you're on this camera, I'm replacing the shutter with that pinhole. Now, pinholes are a pretty fascinating camera. And if you think about it, really, you can make a pinhole camera out of just about anything. I've seen people make pinhole cameras out of rooms and apartment buildings. I've seen people make pinhole cameras out of U-Haul trucks. Also, I've seen someone actually make a pinhole camera using the aperture with their mouth, and they had a piece of film in the back of their mouth. I wouldn't recommend people do that, but I have seen all these things done. And what that is, it's actually science. It's the light from the outside world coming into a darkened room, essentially it's camera obscura, and making an image backwards and upside down. That is how people started a long time ago learning how to draw that way. These were tools. This is history of photography, what I'm talking about, but it is fascinating to me to learn about optics in this way. So what I did was I took an old enlarger lens that has no shutter. And so this is why I have to use the tape. That's what I'm going to use essentially to make my exposure. Now, a lot of this is playing around. This is just guessing. This for me is fun with photography. When I'm working my day-to-day jobs, you know, photography is fun, but it's work. And this to me is more about experimenting and just seeing what comes out, letting my hair down. And you know, it's why I still have a passion for photography. And so that's what I'm going to use. And if you look at the back of the camera, this is where my film is going to go, and my image is going to come onto my film. It's going to, you know, be placed there. And this is Polaroid film. So I'm going to see quickly whether or not I have something. But that doesn't mean that you can't do this. Even with a digital camera, you can make a little pinhole aperture with your lens cap. And it still looks pretty cool. But I'm gonna do it with a very, you know, this camera has seen better days. But I think that it can work, and that's how I'm gonna make a pinhole image with this camera.